I came under Sitaramami's tutelage when I was 7 years old, which is 11 years ago. And I have literally lived and grown in this environment, I think I can say. And Mami has trained me in the Bodhana way of music learning, which is a curriculum developed by Sitaramami. I'm also a national CCRT scholarship holder, which is from the government of India. I finished my 12th standard last year, and now I've enrolled in an undergraduate program. So with Mami's approval, I am going to be singing today's prayer song, which is a composition on Chemungudi Mama by Sita Mami as a homage to her guru. The lyrics are in Sanskrit and it is tuned to Ananda Bhairavi Ragam in Rupa Kathalu. For this privilege to reminisce the most valuable interaction I've had with my guru. Today's presentation focuses on the core aspects that are distinctive to his conception and presentation of music. This would cover his perception on the understanding of the core elements, his imbibing certain finer aspects from other exponents, and masters in the field, and eventually incorporating and internalizing everything to suit his taste, temperament, and voice facility. I would say he was a true jignasu, a perennial seeker. An innate high intelligence and indomitable diligence are the twin hallmarks of this great achiever. God blessed him with many favorable factors: good health, longevity, a disciplined and austere way of life, a very understanding and supportive family, the right mentors at the right time, the ambience that helped him hone his abilities, and the right opportunities that came his way to establish himself as a successful performer, a revered teacher, and a capable administrator. I'm sure some of the elders in this gathering would have memories of listening to him live, and the others, of course, through recordings thanks to technology. Today's presentation would trace the musical journey with a view to highlight the key aspects of his style. This would be interspersed with certain renditions, select renditions. To start with, let us listen to a song popularized by him, Deva Deva Kalayami, in Raga Mayamadugola, from a concert in 1974. To the accompaniment of Sri Lalgudi Jayaraman and Sri Trichy Shankari. This particular Kriti of Swati Thirunal Maharaja has been the commencing item in many of his concerts. And of course, Raga Maya Malagola seems to be one of his favorites. Now let's listen to the song.
Deva Deva Kalayami Yeah.
What a bright and captivating commencement for a kacheri. Kacheri kalakatti aachu. We can visualize Rasika sitting up, looking forward to a bright and absorbing field. Now let's see the factors. The presentation of the kriti is neat with well-conceived sangatis. The general kala pramana is medium speed, madhyama kala, with the brisk effect continuing throughout. And this being the first kriti of the concert, Nirmal and Swarakalpana are also sung in madhyama kala to suit the feel of the kriti. And varied sarvalagu based patterns with all janta and dhatu combinations and resembling tanam rendition are perceived. The numerous crisp swara passages of short duration are typical of his vani, which according to his own admission is an emulation of Aryakudi Ramanujanga. A notable feature is that even in this brisk pace of rendition, we can feel the melodic contours of the raga coming alive in every nook and corner. Despite the cuts and accentuations employed, there is an inlaid continuity of sound, which was probably an innate feature of his voice. Besides this, he perhaps cultivated an intonation, a particular way of intonation, so as to achieve the well-balanced thick and thin output. This is a hallmark of his music. On the whole, even such a fairly elaborate Nirmal and Swarakalpana, which is sung extempore, doesn't seem superfluous and gives the feeling of being an extension of the kriti, a part of a whole. Doesn't seem superfluous. That is the beauty of his music, his conception of music. Now, coming to his growth, he was born in a village with meager facilities for furtherance of knowledge of any kind. For him to become a legendary figure in a specialized field of art is highly creditable, and I would say it's a fortunate occurrence. One may say that being born as a nephew of the renowned, revered violinist Tirukkodi Kaval Krishnayyar was a genetic advantage. But he didn't gain anything because he hardly learned. He didn't learn anything from his uncle though. His parents, fortunately, understood his leaning towards the art. And then right from the early years, they provided him all possible support to further his talents. He was fortunate to come under the tutelage of great teachers. His Sangeeta Vidyabhyasam formally commenced on a Vijayadasami day when he was 7 years old under his elder cousin brother, Chamamudi Narayana Swami Iyer, a nephew, student and son-in-law of Tirukkodi Kaval Krishnayyar. Within a few years, Gurukulavasam, under the care of Kotavargyam Sakharama Rao of Thiruvidamartur, laid a solid foundation. As per his own admission, the few years under this veteran were real fond memories for him. Soon, a shift to Kumbakonam enabled him to come under the tutelage of the renowned Umayalpuram Swaminath Iyer of the Tyagaraja Shishya Parampara, where he acquired a repertoire of sizable stock of compositions. Simultaneously, the ever watchful eyes of his elder cousin brother Chamamudi Narayana Swami Iyer, who was there in Kumbakonam, ensured a rigorous practice regimen which enabled him to acquire power and flexibility of voice. In addition, this mentor prodded him towards absorbing many key aspects needed for becoming a full-fledged musician. The right introduction and opportunities that launched him as a performer came through Maharajpuram Vishwanath Iyer, himself a disciple of Umayalpuram Swaminath Iyer. A few years of Gurukulavasam under him broadened his musical outlook and introduced him to the concert etiquette. He was launched in the musical arena in the early 20s, in his early 20s. His prowess as a performer came to be approved and applauded by even established Vidwans. And there was no looking back after that. Numerous coveted opportunities and positions came his way, and he utilized every one of them to do justice to the fullest, while at the same time constantly improving his abilities and musically and otherwise. Now, coming to the way he shaped his musical idea, one can clearly perceive the influence of Nagaswaram recitals that he was exposed to in his early years in Thiruvidamurthur and Kumbakonam. The haunting and elaborate raga alapanas during temple utsavams and the pulsating mallari renditions really had a great lasting impression on him. The music played by veteran vidwans of that period, like Tiruchere Sarangapani Pillai, Kumbakonam Sivakolundu, Madurai Ponnuswamy Pillai, and Chidambaram Vaidyanath Pillai, Sembunar Kol Ramasamy Pillai, Tiruvedimalai Brothers Subramania Pillai and Natarajachandra Pillai, and all such others formed the initial impressions of Manodharma Sangeeta to this young lad. He seems to have been particularly fascinated by the torrential flow of phrases woven around Swarad by the Nagaswaram player T. N. Rajaratnam. Absorbing such musical ideas, the young Chammamudi is said to have relentlessly tried to replicate them in his voice. The influence of this can be perceived in the way he presented the raga alapana of Karahara Priya in the RPM recording in his early 20s. This was recorded in 1931. Pattern of concert presentation of the trendsetter Ariyakudi Ramanirengar. Like Ariyakudi, he packaged his concerts with a good number and variety of kritis and a shloka in Ragamalika at the concluding segment. In short, he aimed at creating an instant rapport with the listeners, ensuring there was never a dull moment in the whole concert. We can perceive a clear emulation right from his tonal presentation in Raga Alapana, the Kala Pramana of the Kriti edition, and in particular, the numerous avartas of Swarakalpana of short duration, incorporating a variety of patterns. Now we can listen to Narasimha Mamavar in Aravirata.
Yeah. dani da dani da dani da bani dani da bama da baga baga ama bani da da ni dani bani da da baga baga ba baga baga da baga baga ni dani bani da da ni dani bada ni dani 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 da bada bada bama baga baga ama da da baga bani ga baba sani ga baba dani dani ga bani da ga dani dani baba da da dani da dani da baba bani da da dani baba da ma baba dani da ni dani bani da dani bani da dani da da badun da dani da bani da dani bam ma da ma ma da bam ma da baga dani da da baba da dani da dani bani da da baga baga baba dani dani baba dani da dani da dani da dani da dani da dani dani baba da baba da baba da baba da baba da bani da da baga baba dani da dani da baga baba dani da dani 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 da bani da dani da gani baga dani da dani da dani ka baga 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 baga dani And particularly through the music of the inimitable D. Brinda and Bala Saraswati. He was mesmerized by the aesthetic richness and this kept haunting him for life. It is here that his innate intelligence prompted him to work towards a synthesis of the brisk Sarvalaghu based style that he had adopted all the while. With the fluid, nuanced interpretation characteristic of the Dhanamadvani. This attempt became evident not only in the way he perceived and presented the kritis, but also in the way he visualized the grandeur of the kritis. A rich opportunity to use this formula was facilitated by the specific task given to him by the royal family of Travancore to revive, structure and popularize the compositions of Maharaja Swati Thirunal. The influence is seen in the way he has given shape to a number of kritis and padams, particularly in Rakti Ragas. The majestic setting of Sri Kumara Nagaralaya, Akana, Pahitarak Shukuralaya, Ananda Bhairavi, Gangeya Vasanathara Amir Kalyani, and Padams like Hintu Chevu Kalyani, Panimati Bukhibale in Ahiri, Kantanodu Chinnu Melle in Neelambari, Ali Veni in Urunji, and so on. They are all very popular today and brim with Raga Bhava. Now we can hear in his own voice the padam Alarsara Paritapam in Surati Raga.
Na
karna na ya 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 la na 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 adat tadji tadri Yeah.
Composer Papanasham Shivan also influenced his perception of music in certain aspects, particularly emotional content in the enunciation of Sahitya. This way, Chamaguri keenly observed the finer aspects that appealed to him from all corners and synthesized them into his conception of music, and also succeeded in making it his own. Now, from a learner's perspective, there are certain aspects to note in his music. The control and clarity he exhibited in the rendition of swaras in a continuous manner, be it in solfa mode or akara, sometimes even for an array of avartas, is astounding. This is clearly an advantage gained by focused and sustained practice. Maintaining the Madhyamakala effect, the pulsating effect, was very imperative to him. And this is evident not only in his Kriti renditions, but also in Thanam Niravalan Swara Kalpana sections. So we can hear a bit of Thanam in Kirvani Raga.
I got dum dum da dum da ram da ram da ram da
Now coming to the conception of alapana, this raga alapana renditions are developed along characteristic phrases of the raga rather than on a step by step or progressive mode based on swaras. Even in bhava ragas, he intelligently avoided a sagging effect. We can see the way he ends the phrases with a crisp hrasvanyasa, making sure that the swara is clearly heard but not elongated even a bit more than required. Yet we can find him giving sufficient carvings in the key on the key swaras even amidst whirling spate of phrases. This is the way he struck a balance between crispness and poise. We can perceive all these points from the Saveri Alapana that we are going to listen to now.
Mm-hmm.
Presenting the aesthetic feel of the raga was foremost in his mind. Even in the swara kalpana sections, we find every phrase brimming with raga bhava. While maintaining the saralagu feel, he very carefully introduced karvais at the right, on the right swaras, amidst tightly packed phrases. This was also, raga bhava was also brought out in a very nice way. At this juncture, I recall his advice to students. Sing with the feel of the ragas. Sing swaras with the feel of the ragas and not vice versa. Ragatha nanchindu swaram paadu. Swaratha vachindu ragam paadu. This was a very sane advice to his students. Now let's listen to his Kalpana Swaras Var Parivere Nananda Vedi.
Thank you.
bani da ba da go ba ma ga da ma ma ba ma ga ma da ma ma ga da ma ba ba da ga ga ma ba ba da ga da ma ba ba da ba da ni da ba su da ba ba da 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 li da di li da di li da ni da ba ma ba da li da ga di za li da ga di ga ba ga ba ga di za li da ga di da li di za za li ni da za ba ba ma ma ga di ga ma ma di me bagadi gav parre pada 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 bagada tabu bagadi tagadi gav parre dada gada tabu bagava bagava bagadi gav parre pada pada mama bagava tabu bagava bagava gav parre pa pa ni da pa ni da pa da pa da pa ma pa pa ka ni da pa mar ni me pa pa da ni da pa da da pa ga ma da da pa ma ka ni da pa mar ni me pa pa da ni da da ni da pa da pa da da pa ma pa ga ma da pa ma pa pa ga ma ka ni da pa mar ni me mappada bubada 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 gadi gaba mappa tadida bada bappa banida bappa tadida bappa mabida banida banida bada bubada 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 ada bada bada bubada gadi gaba bubada bubada gadi gaba 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 gadi gaba
who boldly ventured to sing Kalpana Swaras in both Vilamba and Madhyama Kala, even for very challenging phrase-based ragas like Neelamari, Yadukula Kamboji, Devagandhari, and even Vijayamani. The beauty is that his Manodharma section gelled as much with the Kriti that it just sounded like an extension.
Gadanam nalinam padayanam Thank you.
da da bu 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 da ba da da bu 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 da ga ma di ga da da de sa.
After the hectic pace for more than 2-4 decades as a successful performing artist and with challenging assignments in the position of principal of the Swati Karnal College of Music in Trivandrum, a key propagator of Swati Karnal's compositions and chief producer at All India Radio, he opted for a relatively peaceful tenure and settled in Chennai. Rid of busy concert schedules and time-bound tasks, he came into an introspective and contemplative mode. In this period, he set to music a number of lyrics and standardized the format of a number of these not so popular critics, particularly of Muthuswami Dikshita. He took a sincere effort to refer to and be faithful to the textual versions in Sangeet Sampradaya Pradarshini, while also referring to the details on the Lakshanas of the Ragas even in other sources also. His uncanny insight into details, combined with the musical maturity he had gained over the years, resulted in the formation of grand aesthetic structures, kritis that he gave shape to and taught his students added to the grandeur of concepts. Musicians, irrespective of their lineage or bani, sought to learn these kritis, like Ranganayakam, Hiranmayi, Shalivatishwaram, Vadanishwaram, Akhilandeshwari, Ardhanadishwaram, and many more. He was instrumental in popularizing and the philosophically and aesthetically rich Kamalamba Navavarna Kritis of Dikshita. More sets of compositions like Ashtapadi, Tirvambavai, Utsava Kirtanas of Swati Tirunal, and a few hymns of Sadashiv Brahmendra and Narayana Tirtha have also been standardized by him. Now, coming to a rare phenomena of the musicians of that era, it is significant that Chembamidi Bama and even his guru Umayalpuram Swaminathayya believed in writing notations for compositions in a period where many musicians scoffed at and disapproved of conceiving or understanding music in terms of words. But look at it, how valuable have these notations been for preserving a neat patandra. How untiringly he would write the notations, it is something to learn. First on a rough paper, then a final copy that is meant for preservation would be very neatly written with all the required symbols, with proper tala markings, and the whole thing accommodated with borders in a large size notebook. You can see this. This is a sample. He made sure to inculcate this habit in all his students. But he was very clear that a song should be written in notation only after learning it thoroughly. Notations were not meant to be looked at while learning. They were meant for preserving them and were only for future reference and preservation. It is this trait and meticulousness that stood by him in all his achievements in life, be it a trivial matter of routine or a mega event involving several business matters. I'm sure all his students, particularly those who have been in close association with him on a regular basis, have unconsciously imbibed such invaluable traits, along with the abundant musical wealth that he gave unconditionally. Now, as a teacher, the popularity he gained among Rasikas as an effective performer of Carnatic music is equally matched by the reverence he commanded in the propagation of the art. He made sure that each line of the song he taught was assimilated clearly by each of his students. He would repeat a line any number of times, explaining how and why the swaras in a phrase are to be handled, connected, elongated, or rendered with a subdued or crisp manner. He would explain the characteristics and aesthetic way of handling phrases in ragas with similar swaras. He would explain the differences. This way, the required elements of lakshana were also taught along with the composition. He was unsurpassed as a guru. His numerous students deemed their association with him as a great blessing, both as a sincere teacher and as a caring father figure. His care and concern for each student extended to ensuring their personal welfare also. He enjoys a singular credit of having tutored hundreds of students. He made sure that his students imbibed the finer aspect of music and passed it on effectively to future aspirants also. An uncanny ability to assess the strengths and weaknesses of his disciple was his great capability. Most of them have turned out to be worthy performers and teachers. This way, his musical vision has kept spreading eternally like a big bang entry. To end the session on a sedate note, we shall listen to a Ragamalika Shloka rendered by him to the accompaniment, Veena accompaniment of Vidwan K.S. Narayan Swami. Let's savor the lingering effect of the music of this legend who breathed music all his life, like Sadaka, Bodhaka, Bhavaka and Gayaka.
Thank you.
dinan Yeah.
Right.
Scholarship in the year 1969 brought me here. At that time, he was already more than 60 years of age, and we were a number of group of students, five of us, learning from him. And it was a great time
we had the privilege of listening to him sing with abandon for hours and hours at home. We were real beneficiaries, I would say. In that period, we got to learn many valuable compositions, particularly kritis of a cluster like the Kamalambana Vavarana kritis, the Vara Kirtanas of Dikshita, the Navavida Bhakti kritis of Swati Tirunal, Ashtapadis, Tirvambave, and so on. And also very grand major kritis we got to learn. I have been a witness to endless hours of untiring effort that went into giving a clear shape to a composition before it was ready for final presentation, with many versions of the same notation in front of him. He would sing each line multiple times with different variations and try to connect the lines, effectively keeping in mind all the necessary aspects with respect to raga bhava, laya, and sahitya bhava. And all that without altering the base notation given in book like Sampradaya Pradeshini or any other notation. The effort would go on for hours and hours and even days, and he wouldn't rest till an aesthetically satisfactory picture emerged. I have been a great beneficiary to observe this process from close quarters, playing the role of a scribe, trying to quickly write notation for all the variations that he sang, singing them repetitively before the final version was arrived at. Apart from his teaching personally, he opened my eyes and heart to look around for many valuable aspects and incorporate them and internalize them into the system, my system. He was very liberal on, it was very liberal on his part to have sent us occasionally to learn from Musili Subramanian Mama. He was also instrumental in introducing me to the style of Dharmal school by personally arranging classes with Muktama to learn Padams and Javalis. He firmly believed that while adhering to the Patantra neatly, a student need not try to imitate the rule. One has to shape his music according to the individual voice, temperament, and taste, and present oneself only after deep deliberation and repeated practice, at least 100 times. And the next aspect, it is my guru who encouraged me to into the arena of music research. In fact, it is on his advice that I shifted to Chennai after a nomadic life for a decade and a half. He was in fact instrumental in bringing me under Professor S.R. Janakiraman as his assistant for the research work on Raga Lakshanas of Tulaja Maharaja and in the music and the wings of the Music Academy. At that period, I was in close touch with him, with my guru, and got an opportunity to discuss and broaden my perspective on the nuances of various ragas. It was only his encouragement that I later ventured into my project of a modified curriculum for learners of music, particularly the introductory lessons. He has always been of the opinion that the traditional introduction to music with the swaras of Mayavada Gola was not quite effective to vocal music. After considerable thought and trials with students, I arrived at the system of initially introducing Audava Ragas ragas are with 5 notes, pentatonic scales, where swaras are well spaced and require minimum gamakas. I had the approval of my guru at every stage as I progressed on these lines. And finally, a comprehensive system which I call Bodhana emerged. Although he encouraged this bold attempt, he cautioned me and advised me to try out all this for a considerable period of time with many students before I came out with my ideas. In fact, he advised me his advice was that my music treasure that I have imbibed should be passed on to the future generation. That is what his expectations on me was. Heeding to his advice, I started the institution Balabrindam in Chennai in 1992 with the aim of creating a holistically equipped artist who will carry on the legacy forward to future generations. Many of our group thematic presentations had his approval, and some of them were witnessed by him also. He was very happy and proud of this progress. There have been occasions when I visited him with my students to seek his blessings. One such occasion on a Vijayadashami day, you can see in the photo. All the elder students today have become performing artists, teachers, and most of them have doctoral degrees in music. And one of the little ones who is sitting here, she is doing her PhD, and she has continued for nearly 20 years. She'll explain her.
Anand Krishnan, a disciple of Sita Mami at Balabrindam Sangeeta Gurukulam. I, like many other students, started learning from Sita Mami at a very young age. The atmosphere while growing up in the Gurukulam was always filled with music. I mean, apart from the time we were taught personally, we were also exposed to so many allied subjects in a very organic way. We hardly knew it was happening. And it was much like the traditional Gurukulam atmosphere, semi-Gurukulam atmosphere in this time and age, I would say. Balabrindam Gurukulam is a place where we learn art for the sake of the art itself. And for the sole aim of passing this treasure we have to the future generations as scholars, teachers, and as performers. After completing our school education, many of our students opted to pursue undergraduate, postgraduate, as well as research studies towards a doctorate in music. Many of us, with the blessings of our guru, are national scholarship holders at various levels, starting from the junior scholarship to a middle senior scholarship to a junior research or a senior research fellowship of the Government of India. And most of us are also graded artists of the All India Radio and performing regularly. Today, we have been able to teach students through the Bodhana method, which is extremely appealing to students all around the world, be it in person or on online mode. And we have the response we get from students who seem to be enjoying those classes are amazingly satisfying to all of us. We also perform concerts, present papers, and give lectures from time to time in various venues. All this, nothing of this would be possible without the blessings and the tutelage and the treasure we have gained from our Guru Sita Mami. Our Guru has inculcated in us that music is a lifelong sadhana, it's a lifelong learning. And this, as we have seen today, was the motto of our Paramaguru, Sangeeta Pitamaha Sarvamuri Srinivasayya. Today being his Shraddhanjali, we have all been extremely fortunate to have heard from one of his prime disciples, Sita Mami, on who has taken us on an incredible journey of his life, music, and his legacy. We students of Balavrindam have been blessed to learn many compositions that have been set and standardized by him, including the Kamalamba Navavarna Kirtanas of Muthuswami Dikshitar. Sitamami has been singing the Navavarna Kirtanas at Thiruvarur for 25 years. And for our small part, we have also been able to go a few times with Mami and had the opportunity and blessing to perform at Thiruvarur and at Navavarna Pujas, even in Chennai here. So today, we would like to conclude this program with the Mangala Kirtana of the Navavarna, Kamalamba Navavarna set, Shri Kamalambike Indra Raga Shri.
Shri Kamalambike Shri Bhepa Lalite Shri Kamalambike Shri Bhepa Lalite Shri Kamalambike Shri Bhepa Lalite Shri Pati Vimute Sita Sita Shiva Sahite Shri Kamalambike Shri Vepa Lalite Shri Pati Vimute Sita Sita Shiva Sahite Shri Kamalambike Shri Vepa Raka Chandra Mukhi Rakshivatola Mukhi Raka Chandra Mukhi Rakshivatola Mukhi Rama Vani Sakhi Raja Yoga Sukhi Rama Vani Sakhi Raja Yoga Sukhi Shankari Ekakshari Bhuvaneshwari Ishapiyakari Chitari Sukakari Shirmaka Tripura Sundari Shikamalambike Shirmaka Lalite Shri Pati Vimute Sita Sita Shiva Sahite Shri Kamalambike